One of the questions I've been asked a lot over the past 2 years is, what is the startup procedure on my diesel swapped XJ? And I think the general notion is that it's got to be complicated. It's got to be something different than factory. The answer to that question is, it's not. Super simple. I've got this thing set up right, and today we're going to dive into the startup procedure of my diesel swapped XJ. Ever since I finished the diesel conversion on my 99 XJ, I've been getting tons of questions about anything you could think of. And my objective with this YouTube channel is to kind of curate all of that data, all those questions, answer them here, but also take you on the journey as I do other adventures. I go wheeling, off-roading, camping, things like that. But today's video is super short. One of the questions I've gotten a lot recently, believe it or not, is the startup procedure on my 99 XJ. And the thing that I wanted to just kind of portray to people is that when you embark on a diesel conversion, in my opinion, one of your objectives should be to make it as close to factory as possible. So I don't have a ton to talk about on this topic because I achieved that. And what I mean by that is every function of this Jeep, how you drive it, how you start it, how you shut it off, all the AC, the controls, heat, things like that, all functions just like it did from factory. The one thing that I wanted to say before I actually dive a little bit deeper into that topic is, you can tell we're at a different location. We parked at some random highway bridge out here in Reading, Pennsylvania. I don't know why, it just looked cool, so we decided, hey, that's what we're gonna do today. But besides that, guys, this is a different channel. And I said this in my last two videos, this channel's new, and it again is curating the Jeep content into one location because I recognize that you guys aren't into necessarily everything that I have going on the other channels. But if you're into that kind of stuff, guns, shooting, training, definitely check out Keystone Carry and check out my company page, TA Targets. We've got a lot of cool stuff going on over there. Back onto the topic of the startup procedure with the Jeep. If you can insert a key into the ignition and you can turn a key, you can start and drive this Jeep. And that's exactly how I made it. So the only caveat to that, the only little bit of a difference between this and a stock Jeep is the fact that the OM617 does have glow plugs. These glow plugs are in the pre-chambers for the injectors. And when the Jeep is cold, it's very important to use those glow plugs. Otherwise, the diesel engine is just going to crank and crank and crank. You'll get some cool smoke out the exhaust when you do that, but it's gonna take forever to start. It's really hard on the engine. So when I insert my key, as you saw in the B-roll sequence at the beginning, there's a little switch that I put in front of my four-wheel drive selector. The reason I put it there is because I didn't wanna accidentally bump it or accidentally turn it on. It wouldn't really hurt the Jeep if you accidentally left it on, but it is really bad for the glow plugs. So when I get in, turn the key forward, I usually let those glow plugs stay on for about 10 or 15 seconds. And after that, you just start it like normal. And the cool thing is, once this thing is up to operating temp and you've been driving it for a while, you don't even have to do that. You just get in, turn the key, fire it up, and shutting it down is exactly the opposite. So you just simply turn the key off. I've got a vacuum solenoid switch on the dash, or on the firewall, I should say. That activates the fuel shut off and it's gonna shut the Jeep down. As far as how the glow plugs work, it's just a Ford starter solenoid. Super easy, guys. This stuff is not complex, not complicated to do. So as you guys can tell, I kept the simple factory function of the on off of the key. And that's the whole objective with this Jeep, is keep it as close to factory while being a diesel conversion. Because ultimately, I don't think that if you have a diesel conversion that requires you to do a song and dance and jump through hoops and do all kinds of crazy stuff just to get it started, I feel like it's not really a good conversion, and that's not totally up to snuff with what it could be. So guys, this channel, like I said, is all about getting you information about this swap, hopefully encouraging you along if you are in that process, but also taking you on the journey of all the other adventures we're gonna go on. If you have any questions about the diesel swap, please leave them down in the comments below. Take a second, like, subscribe, And please consider sharing this video on your favorite Jeep Facebook group, favorite Jeep forum, things like that. Get this spread out to the masses, because I know there's a lot of people that are wondering what it takes to convert a Jeep and whether or not it's worth it. And it's all gonna depend on your situation. It's all gonna depend on what you can do personally. But ultimately, I'm hoping that this tells the story about that and helps out anybody who's considering doing that. So guys, I appreciate you tuning into this video. Check you out in the next one.